Alex?
Telsia, hi.
Penny for your thoughts?
What's a penny?
I don't know. Some old phrase I heard Paris say once. It was a nice service. For Beastman and the others.
Yeah, for a funeral.
You couldn't have helped them, you know. You did the best you could. They knew the risks. They were professionals.
I know, but when you disappeared in the Aetherian ship, I told myself the same thing. It didn't make me feel any better then, either.
You can't bring them back. Don't live in the past. Look toward the future. You have a bright future.
Do I?
Sure. Trust me.
Is this a private party, or can anyone join?
How are you doing, Monroe?
As good as can be expected, I guess.
Lieutenant Monroe?
Those pips suit you well, Lieutenant.
Thank you, sir.
You had us worried there at the end.
Mr. Monroe disobeyed orders and did not board the escape shuttle.
I'm sorry, sir. There was something I had to do.
We know, Lieutenant. We all saw the alien visions. You did what you had to do.
It was commendable. You were willing to sacrifice yourself for the whole.
As did the entire team. You all performed bravely.
The Hazard team has proven to be more valuable than we imagined. Starfleet just might adopt your idea when we get back, Tuvok.
Thank you, Captain. But I think Mr. Monroe is the one most responsible for the success of the team. It took some time, and not inconsiderable effort. But you have proven yourself to be an outstanding officer and a natural leader, as I always believed you would.
Thank you, sir. I was afraid you would think my decision was too impulsive.
Sometimes, Lieutenant, your gut instinct is better than what logic and procedure would suggest. Both are needed in a good leader. That is why I chose you to begin with.
Yes, sir. I understand.
Why, Tuvok? Is that a bit of pride I detect?
Surely, Captain. There is no cause to insult me.